live at 6.
The UNM football team has literally taken a hit at the quarterback position, relying on its third-string QB in last week's 7-point loss at Wyoming.
KOAT Action 7 News Sports Director Orlando Sanchez is here with the latest.
The Lobos have some similarities with their next opponent. Utah State lost their starting quarterback to injury and played two quarterbacks last week. UNM could be without its top quarterbacks due to injury and began the week not knowing who will be ready to play at that position.
We had a number one defense in the country. Danny Marino was our quarterback. We're up 28-0 on Boston College. And they bring a guy in off the bench named Doug Flutie. And Doug Flutie almost upset us up in Chestnut Hill. I'll never forget it.
The clock was turned all the way back to a time a backup QB became a star. The Lobos could be hoping for the same success in their third-string quarterback, David Vega. With Cole Gauchy recovering from a knee injury and Clayton Mitchum experiencing concussion symptoms, the former Goddard standout leads the depth chart. Vega completed a touchdown pass in the Lobos' final possession against Wyoming. But Bob Davey isn't ready for the Doug Flutie comparisons after one completed pass.
There's a reason he was third on the depth chart before injuries. And there'll be a reason if two guys are healthy, he'll be third on the depth chart again.
Both Gauchy and Mitchum are listed as day-to-day. They have not been ruled out of Saturday's matchup against Utah State. And the Lobos' starting quarterback decision may come down to one thing.
It's based on health. And if Cole's healthy enough, I think everybody sees Cole should be the guy that's out there for us. And if I knew right now who was the healthiest and where we were, I'd make my decision. You know, I've never tried to keep any of that stuff a secret.
Gauchy and Mitchum were on the practice field today, but were limited. Bob Davey says he doesn't plan to make a decision on a starter until late this week.
The UNM versus Utah State game starts at 7 p.m. on Saturday at University Stadium. It will be televised on Root Sports.